You are Arian? Sorry, say it again. Arian. Nice to meet you, man. Alright, E4, E5. Knight F3, Knight C6. Old school. No, Knight C6. It says Knight C6, and then it says Bishop B5, Knight F6. I think so. Knight C6, Bishop B5, Knight F6. Yeah, that's right. Oh, you know what? The board's wrong. Sometimes that happens with the notation. We set up white and black wrong. Don't worry about it. Actually, it's good training, okay? Because it helps you to learn how to visualize the board. You know that this square is actually F6?
Did you look at the other game before?
I know it says C3, but it's actually F6. Raise your right hand. Okay, you solemnly swear. White is on the right, okay? And the queen is on her color because the dress has to match the shoes. Then everybody's happy. That's all you need, okay? White on the right, queen's on her color. This is actually A8, not H1 for today, okay? Just have fun with it, like we're imagining stuff. All right, knight F6 now. And now he took bishop C6. You played B takes C6?
Yeah, it's not on the board.
Okay, why'd you take with the B pawn instead of the D pawn? Okay, that's very good, actually. One of the classical rules is don't take away from the center, take toward the center, right? So that's what you were taught. In this case, this actually doesn't apply for multiple reasons. Number one, if you take with the D pawn, you're actually opening up this bishop and opening up the queen, so you're facilitating your development. And in the beginning of the game, the faster you get your pieces out, the better. Okay, facilitates a big word. But there's actually a second long-term reason. Can you think of another reason why I don't like this move? It has to do with the pawns, the little guys. Yeah, what kind of pawn is that? Isolated, right? And so, you want to have the least amount of pawn islands as you can, okay? You ever seen Castaway? Tom Hanks? Wilson? So you've never had any experience with desert islands, ever. Right, okay. So desert islands can be bad. You don't want a lot of islands, all right? Now here you're gonna have two islands anyway. One pawn island, two pawn islands. But this is a better mass because these four can help each other and these four can help each other. Whereas this mass with one ISO, as we call them, is not as good, okay? Plus the B file is not nearly as useful as the D file. The B file is not as useful as the D file, all right? Okay, this is a good lesson. You take with the D pawn, no, you took with the B pawn here. Knight takes E5, queen to E7. By the way, if the queen was here, if it was open, you would be able to play this move. It's a little bit better. Double attack, and then you get to take with check and ruin his right to castle. Okay. Now with the knight's hanging. So if knight moves, you take, you trade queens, and he can't castle, right? Okay. Yeah, but if you go here, I'm gonna play D4. And it is different. Yeah, you take this pawn, but let me ask you something. When I castle, are you happy with this queen and this development here? This queen blocks the bishop, and if that bishop can't move, what happens? You can't what? You can't castle. So if you can't castle, and the bishop can't move, and then I start getting action going here on the E-file, how does that feel? No bueno, right? No, you're gonna lose material here for realsies. This isn't gonna be good, okay? So, it's not just a choice. The reason why I'm emphasizing this is not because I want to drill in the point, but because I want to emphasize it isn't just a choice like this pawn or this pawn. This pawn is much better. Taking this way is much better. There's even a third reason I didn't say. We're talking about the bad isolated pawn, we're talking about development and this queen move. There's a fourth reason, okay? The fourth reason is that you have the bishop pair here. Your opponent gave up the bishop. You have two bishops and he has one bishop. Have you ever heard that the bishop pair is better than the knights? Okay, why is that, you think?
You should have traded. You got greedy.
The bishops can go long ways, right? And most positions will eventually become open. It takes a much better player to dictate a position to stay closed than it does to let it become open. What happens when all you kids play? You guys just trade pieces like crazy, right? So you open the position. Most of the time, the bishops are better, so you want to open it up. So in this position, queen e7, if I play d4, oh wait, you actually did take with this pawn, so you could play this move, although it would lose a pawn. And if you take with check, I can block, and you can't take. So it's still not good for you. But okay, let's see what happened here. You played queen e7, and your opponent just retreated. That helps you. You should have taken with the queen. Definitely should have taken with the queen. You're going to get in big trouble after this movie. Castles, and now you're regretting it. Queen d8, and for some reason, he does you a favor. He could play rook e1, and then play d3, and you lose a piece. Instead, he attacked the knight first, and you were able to move the knight back, right? And then he played rook to e1. He actually didn't, actually. No, he played bishop before. He still could have played this move, and then followed that up with this move, which would make your life a little bit difficult because you can't castle. But a little bit of a lack of knowledge by this guy, not really knowing that the e-file was where he needed to be. Okay, so you got a little bit lucky, but I still want you to focus on the mistakes we talked about out of the opening, right? Bad way to take, not recognizing the bishop pair, and could have had more problems here. I call the queen there the old lady who swallowed the fly. Okay, you know the moral of that story? Does anybody really know the moral of that story? I guess don't swallow flies is actually the moral of the story. No, never mind. We won't talk about that. That happens from time to time. I get a little sidetracked. All right, here we go. D3, knight f6, bishop f4, knight d5, queen d2.
Okay.
I still think he should be using the e-file here, but he's not. Bishop to d6, he chops it. Sure, why not? Bishop takes, pawn takes.
Very good.
He's offering a lot of trades. You guys like to trade. That's great. Wait, he takes, and then now he decides to give a check. A little intermezzo, right? A swish and zook. You know what a swish and zook is? Yeah. Did you know what a swish and zook is? In between move? What is that? No, a swish and zook is a... It's a move you play in between a forcing sequence. So the obvious move when someone takes a piece is to just take back. A swish and zook is a high quality move you play in between, like a check, and it kind of makes your position even better. So even though he should have done this much earlier, as we've been talking about, it was a well-timed move because he takes away your right to castle and only then takes back the knight. So it's called an intermezzo. It's good for you because really in this position, it's a good lesson for you, not good for you. Because in this position, you should have recognized the possible intermezzo and got castled, which you could have done for a few moves. You're really breaking some opening principles here, man. I mean, you're moving pieces twice before you're castled. That's a big no-no. Grandmasters don't even do that. All right? Think of it as like a team. You ever played basketball on a team? You ever played... What other sports have you played? Soccer? Okay. So you have a coach that tells you to kick the ball to everybody one time before you score because they're trying to get you to use the whole team and share your pieces, all right? So these guys are so unhappy, I might as well just take them off the board. They're not using them. They're lonely. You ever been lonely? Not fun. All right, knight takes, rook to e1 check, king f8, queen takes c3. Okay, queen f6, now he doesn't trade queens, he backs up. All right. Okay, how did you do with this game? I know, I'm just saying that, did you eventually lose the game? Okay. But I really want you to take to heart a lot of the things we've been talking about here. I have a little reality check. This position right here, at a high level, is already just totally lost because of your bad king and because of your lack of development. So we can talk about, you know, what maybe happens in a few moves, but you're already in big trouble. And more than that, you're never going to get this exact position again. Like, I'm serious. All right, I've played so many chess games, and you just rarely get the exact complicated middle game again. So if I talk about, you know, like, not taking here and giving up this check, you're never going to get that position again. But you will get a similar position where the choice is the same. Should I move a piece twice, or should I get castled? You have to castle before you start moving pieces twice. That is just a general principle that applies across the board. Okay, figuratively, no pun intended, okay? Applies everywhere. So, you taking with the B pawn, that's a mistake. You will get that position again, and that's a universal tip to not take that way, right? And this way that you approach the position where you started moving pieces and leaving the E-file open, those are things that in almost any case, that's the wrong thing for you to do. Okay? So you can tell your, and you don't have to listen to it, you can tell yourself that you only lost the game because of one other mistake later, but it's not true. You actually lose the game because of many little mistakes that lead to bigger issues. Okay? So you're moving the queen, you're not developing your pieces, your king is in the center. Problem town. Problem town. I know, but I'm emphasizing all these little things, but every move, really, the best move is like, you gotta get your development complete. You finally got the bishop out. You know, there's really not a lot of options. You have to get your pieces out, okay? And the longer you don't do that, the worse it's gonna get. I know, but that's if chess. I'm not gonna move the pawn, right? Instead, I'm gonna go here. Oh no, he didn't. He played here. But still, so now you do this. All right, well, maybe you'll have a chance to make it up. He gets in here. You take another pawn. You're pawn grabbing. You're gonna regret it. Don't go pawn or grabbing.
One point is enough for me to win the game. Right? 3 points is way too much.
Owie, it's over. And just like that, it was just a matter of time.
You're giving up 3 points, but not even enough reason. But if you're gonna give up 3 points, you better either win 3 points back.
Yeah, but I mean, you're already, you know, this is toast, man. No, he didn't play that. He played, you played queen A5. Oh, he did play here. And you agreed to checkmate? You gotta take your time, homie. FYI, you're checkmated next move. That's okay. All right, so don't beat yourself up about it. But but yes, you're right. I mean, you could have taken here, right? Make the final checkmate. Yeah. All right. Well, you know what? These are really good lessons. All right. What's your rating?
Head on points trade.
You don't know your rating? Okay, that's great. So it's going up, right? So just learn from these little, all the things we talked about in this game can be applied to future games. That's the reason we're doing this. All right, we're not going over this game just to embarrass you in front of all these people. That's another reason. Kidding. All right, we're done. All right, you want your game reviewed?